The Church of Uganda has issued restrictions on the use of its regalia by musicians, dramatists, and entertainers. Through their lawyer, Muhaire Naboth, Church of Uganda has registered 42 regalia with the Uganda Registration Service Bureau. According to the church, any musician or artist found recording music videos or performing while putting on church regalia will be prosecuted.
Kati omuntu anasangibwa ng'ayambadde ekyambalo ekyefaanaanyiriza ekya Bishop owa Church of Uganda nga kiri wano nga bwe zirambikiddwa wano mu New Vision, oyo agenda kukangavulwa amateeka.
However, they have put a provision for whoever intends to use the regalia to apply for it through the relevant authorities detailing how they intend to use it. This, they say, will ensure that it is used for the glory of God. Speaking at their head office in Namirembe, the Church of Uganda's leadership explained the different regalia used and their functions. They further laid out the penalties that will be slapped on whoever defies the set restrictions.
Center, I met one of the persons seated on a border came out, and then he went to the market and he was pushing a wheelbarrow. And he was putting on the bishop's attire, the shirt, the purple. We said, no, these things are going very far.
Bishop of South Ankole, Right Reverend Nathan Ahimbisiwe, emphasized the reasons why the Church of Uganda has placed restrictions on the use of its regalia. These restrictions come at a time when Graviton Tuju, an artist, angered the Uganda Medical Association following his music video while wearing a medical uniform. According to the medical professionals, the message depicted in the video was a misrepresentation of their profession. The hearing of the case in the murder of city businessman Henry Katanga resumed today before the presiding High Court Judge Isaac Mowata. Today, court listened to the testimony of Mugabe Ronald, a close associate of the late Katanga. Mugabe, a lawyer working with Mugabe and Company Advocates at Nkrumah Road, took the stand as the sixth prosecution witness. In his testimony, Mugabe said the day Katanga was murdered was the same day he was set to make his will. He also affirmed to the court that he is very familiar with Molly Katanga, the late Katanga's wife, because he was involved in most activities and parties in the family, including when marrying off his daughters. He further described the late Katanga's personality, saying he was a calm person who cared about his life. He said that on November 1st last year, he was supposed to meet the late Katanga, but the meeting was postponed to November 2nd. However, on the same day, at midday, he received a phone call informing him about the demise of Katanga.
It was around 12 when we received the call. That Katanga, we are waiting for, is dead.
He said the news prompted him to reinforce the security at his office with another lock, suspecting that Katanga's killers could steal his documents.
I came to know later from a one woman that the purpose why he wanted to see me, he wanted to make him a will.
Who was Naume to Katanga?
Naume was his sister.
However, the defense lawyers rejected Mugabe's testimony, saying that he's not a lawyer, and they supported their claim with a document from the court clerk. They sought to have the document issued and used as evidence.
There is no paper ground that has been led to establish a nexus between the witness and the document. They can bring the chief regent from my office as the author.
The prosecution lawyers, led by attorney Jonathan Mwaganya, also rejected the document presented by the defense unless the court clerk presented it in person. The seventh witness in the late Katanga's murder case is his sister, Nome Nyagweso. However, the court adjourned the hearing to August 20th. 10 years after Malaysia Airlines flight MH17 was blasted from the sky over war-torn Ukraine, families of the victims will gather Wednesday to remember the tragedy as hopes fade that those responsible will soon be behind bars. Hundreds of relatives, as well as government representatives and dignitaries, are expected to attend the event at a memorial park near Schiphol Airport, where the doomed flight took off on a bright summer's day on July 17, 2014. Hours later, before the jet was shot down by a Russian-made Buk surface-to-air missile over eastern Ukraine, as it passed on a flight line toward Kuala Lumpur, all 298 people on board died. A Dutch court has sentenced in absentia three men to life imprisonment for their roles in bringing down the plane over separatist-held pro-Russian territory during the early stages of a war that saw Moscow seize the Crimean Peninsula. On Wednesday, the names of all the victims, 196 of them Dutch, will be read during the commemoration of its organizers. Hours later, before the jet was shot down by a Russian-made Buk surface-to-air missile over eastern Ukraine, as it passed on a flight line toward Kuala Lumpur, all 298 people on board died. A Dutch court has sentenced in absentia three men to life imprisonment for their roles in bringing down the plane over separatist-held pro-Russian territory during the early stages of a war that saw Moscow seize the Crimean Peninsula.
Duizenden kilometers verderop, in het oosten van Oekraïne.
Wij vorderen de verdachte Girkin, Dubinsky, Pulatov en Gartchenko, ieder voor het in vereniging doen verongelukken van een vliegtuig met de dood tot gevolg en de moord in vereniging op 298 inzittenden te veroordelen tot een levenslange gevangenisstraf.
On Wednesday, the names of all the victims, 196 of them Dutch, will be read during the commemoration, its organizers said. 43 Malaysians and 38 Australians were also among the victims from 10 countries. Last year, international investigators suspended their work, saying there was not enough evidence to prosecute more suspects. Australia and the Netherlands have an ongoing case against Russia with the International Civil Aviation Organization, a United Nations agency with limited enforcement powers. Russia has denied any involvement and dismissed the 2022 court verdict as scandalous and politically motivated.